This is TWiT.
Apple's going to come up against a problem in Russia soon. In November, the parliament, as we've talked about before, passed what Fast Company calls the law against Apple. The law requires all smartphone devices in Russia to preload Russian apps, ostensibly to support the Russian economy, but I think it's also feared that those Russian apps might provide information to the government about its citizens. Apple always prohibits this. The law goes into effect in July, and some say, Fast Company says, this is going to force Apple to decide, do we allow Russia to put spyware on our phones, or do we pull out of the market? What would you do, Devindra?
I mean, it'd be nice to see Apple kind of resist this somewhat, but I mean, every tech company is fine doing business in China, and right. That also involves quite a few, you know, privacy related issues there too. Except they're not preloading things in China, but it also seems like it's only a matter of time until that's something that's going
to
happen.
Well, too. And Apple had to move the iCloud servers to China for Chinese customers, presumably to companies that the Chinese government could then get into the servers.
For sure.
It's tough. We are now in a much more global environment than ever before. Markets are global, and yet every country has its own laws. Every state has its own laws. Look at California with our new Privacy Act. All of a sudden, companies have to kind of do something separate for California than they might do in the rest of the country.
Yeah, but for Apple especially, this is so different from, you know, their whole philosophy of we own the device. Like, it's pure. We do software and hardware. You know, even, they still sell to China, but it's the same
essential
phone.
That's like an aesthetic thing, though. That's not a privacy thing. It's an aesthetic thing.
Well, no, but what I'm saying is that, right, beyond the questions of kowtowing to various regimes' requests and things like that, like, I can see that it's also a little different because Apple would essentially have to give up what it has said, you know, its entire life. Like, you know, we make the product we deliver to you is exactly the way we want it to be. As opposed to, well, in Russia, you're going to get some sort of chintzy mail or maps app or whatever.
Yeah.
But they also seems that like, they didn't they remove the news app and for the China market too? I mean, they have
made concessions. They took the Chinese flag
for governments before.
They took the Taiwanese flag off the emojis in Hong Kong and China. They've done that kind of thing all along, right?
Around the edges, but again, what I'm saying
around
is
around the edges. Yeah,
if it's a Russian photo app alongside photos, if it's a
big deal.
But all down the line, if it's email, if it's the browser, I'm assuming is the prime thing that the government wants to load up there as well.
Well, it'll be very interesting. Come July, I can't wait to see.
This is one situation where it seems like the business value, if it's $3 billion or something close to that, it's not that big to Apple, a company with such a huge war chest. Like, they can take that hit and have the goodwill of being the company that said no to Vladimir Putin, basically.
I think they would love that.
Yeah.
Except then China comes along. And now you got a problem. So as soon as you make a concession to Russia, you got to play the chess game a couple moves ahead. Now China's going to come to you and say, yeah, we'd like to do the same thing. Now what do you do? Because you can't leave China.